Greetings of the day, dear students. The previous class, we have been discussing about anaerobic digestion and the speciality of the digester and the important application of anaerobic digestion is methanogenesis and production of biogas. The next topic illustrated in this unit number 4 of sanitation microbiology, this is one of the important and potential application of microbiology to the human beings and the society, that is methanogenesis and production of biogas. And methanogenesis, we have discussed, this is an important step of anaerobic digestion. This is the final step of digestion, and the digestion process is started from the hydrolysis, then acidogenesis, then acetogenesis. The last step is methanogenesis, and methanogenesis, otherwise known as biomethanation, which is a formation of methane by microorganism known as methanogens. And this organism capable of producing methane, which are mainly belongs to archaeobacteria. And the production of methane is an important and widespread form of microbial metabolism. Lot of microorganisms are involving, especially anaerobic organisms are involving in this particular process, and this microorganism convert the waste material, especially solid waste, into useful form of bioresources, that is biogas. And this is happening in an anoxic environment, where the final step, it is the decomposition of the biomass. And methanogenesis is responsible for the significant contribution of natural gas that is accumulated in the ecosystem. And as I mentioned, this is a final step of anaerobic digestion. The digestion contains four main important steps: hydrolysis, acetogenesis, that is acidogenesis, acetogenesis, and methanogenesis. So the last step is known as the methanogenesis. The hydrolysis, the complex material such as carbohydrate, protein, lipids, that is converted into soluble organic form such as sugars, amino acid, and fatty acid by certain hydrolytic bacteria, and that is produced this end product. Once this end product is done, then the acidogenesis happens, and this molecule directly converted into hydrogen, carbon dioxide, methane, ammonia, then hydrogen sulfide or acetic acid. Or this produces alcohols, carbonic acids, and volatile fatty acid. And once this is produced, the acetogenesis process, the formation of acetic acid, will be happening from this step and this step to produce acetic acid. And in addition to this, it will produce hydrogen, carbon dioxide, ammonia, and sulfur dioxide, hydrogen sulfide. And this hydrogen, carbon dioxide, ammonia, and hydrogen sulfide converts to form methane and carbon dioxide, and this acetic acid also produces, that is synthesis of this methane will take place, and carbon dioxide will be produced as the one of the important products. So this is the overview of the anaerobic digestion, and the last step is known as methanogenesis. So the next step is the mechanism of methanogenesis. So the methane fermentation is a consequence of a series of metabolic process which require so many microorganisms, which are collectively known as methanogens, and most of the methanogens are archaeobacteria. In this step, the first group of microorganisms, That is, the hydrolytic organisms secrete as the enzyme which hydrolyze the complex polymeric material into small monomeric units such as glucose and amino acid, and later it convert higher volatile fatty acid, hydrogen and acetic acid. That is known as acidogenesis. The next step, hydrogen producing acetogenic bacteria convert this fatty acid, hydrogen and acetic acid, especially volatile fatty acid, to hydrogen, carbon dioxide and acetic acid. So here in addition to volatile fatty acid, the other fatty acids such as propionic acid and butyric acids are also involved, which forms hydrogen, carbon dioxide and acetic acid. The last step, the methanogenic bacteria convert this hydrogen, carbon dioxide, acetate to methane and carbon dioxide. So these are the various process that is involved in this mechanism. So this is what we have told. So here you can see the involvement of various microorganisms, that is the particularly insoluble organic matter such as carbohydrate, protein and lipids, the hydrolytic bacteria are act on this particular organic matter and produces amino acid, sugar, alcohol and fatty acid. That is done by the hydrolytic bacteria. The major hydrolytic bacteria are Acetovibrio, Cellulolyticus and Bacteriodetes. Okay, so then once this amino acid, sugars, alcohols, fatty acids are produced, then acidogenesis are happening, the formation of acid, that is high level of volatile fatty acid, that is acetic acid, propionic acid, ethanol and lactic acid will be happening by using acidogenic bacteria. The major acidogenic bacteria is Campylobacter and Peptococcus, and this process is known as acidogenesis, formation of acids. Then this intermediary product such as volatile fatty acid, acetate, propionate, ethanol, lactate will converted into acetate and carbon dioxide and hydrogen, and this is known as acetogenesis, and this is carried out by acetogenic bacteria such as Centrophobacter wolini and Centrophomonas wolfii. Okay, so these are the two important acetogenic bacteria, and this acetate will be converted by acetoelastic bacteria into biogas, that is methane and carbon dioxide, and this carbon dioxide and hydrogen, that is converted into hydrogenotrophic bacteria to biogas, that is mainly methane, and this process is the methanogenesis. And the major acetoclastic methanogenic bacteria are Methanocarcina burkeri and Methanocyta. Okay, so these are acetoclastic methanogen. Next one, acetoorganotrophic methanogens are Methanobacterium arbophilicum and Methanobacterium fervidius. Okay, so Methanobacterium arbophilicum and Methanobacter fervidius are the major types of hydrogen organotrophic methanogen. So this is the major mechanism of methanogenesis. Then the next one is the biochemistry of methanogenesis. The methanogenesis in microbes is a form of anaerobic respiration, anaerobic digestion, where methanogens, they will not utilize oxygen, they utilize only carbon dioxide. So this oxygen will be inhibiting the growth of microorganism, especially methanogens, where the terminal electron acceptor in this respiration is not oxygen but it is carbon. Okay, and the carbon can occur in small number of organic components, all with a low molecular weight. And the best two pathway involved in the use of this particular step is the use of acetic acid or inorganic carbon dioxide as terminal electron acceptor. I told you the terminal electron acceptor is carbon component such as acetic acid or a carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide combines with hydrogen to produce methane and water. Similarly, acetic acid produces methane and carbon dioxide. So this is the actual mechanism and biochemistry of methanogenesis. So during this particular digestion of the carbohydrate, the hydrogen and acetate are formed in the ratio of 2:1, where hydrogen constitute 33% of methanogenesis and acetate constitute the remaining percentage of methanogenesis, that is a greater portion. So based on the pH and temperature, the methanogenesis has been shown to use carbon from other small organic components such as formic acid, methanol, methylamines, tetramethyl ammonium, dimethyl sulfide, and the methane ethyol. Okay, so these are the other types of small organic components. And this methyl components, the catabolism of this methyl components are mainly catalyzed by methyl transferases, which gives methyl coenzyme M. So the biochemistry of methanogenesis involves the following, such as the enzymes such as coenzymes and the cofactors, that is F420, coenzyme B, coenzyme M, methanofuran and methanopterin. Okay, so these are the major biochemical aspects of methanogenesis. Now one of the ultimate outcome of this methanogenesis were commonly in agricultural farm, especially in domestic use, in household use, it is using in the form of biogas. So biogas, this is the combination of the end product obtained from methanogenesis, is known as biogas. So how will you produce biogas? This picture depict the small representation of biogas production. So the livestock waste from various animals, the crop waste and the waste water and the food waste, okay, all those things are collected and undergoing anaerobic digestion. It comprises of four steps: hydrolysis, acidogenesis, acetogenesis and methanogenesis. Then finally the methane and carbon dioxide will be produced as a biogas. The biomethane can be used as a fuel and gas grid, and that is used as a heat and electricity. Then the slurry that is obtained from this bio digester can, that is known as a digestate, that can be used as a fertilizer, soil conditioner and livestock bedding, as we have discussed in the previous class. And this is the overall steps that is involved in the biogas production in a small scale level. First you have to collect all this waste, that can be livestock waste, the crop waste from agricultural crop or waste water or food materials, etc. Then you need to do a pre-treatment. You have to shred it or minced, or mix it properly. Then you have to homogenize this waste material in a tank, and you have to all the waste that is the slurry, you have to feed it into an anaerobic digester or a tank, where it will happen the anaerobic digestion, such as hydrolysis, acidogenesis, acetogenesis and methanogenesis. Finally, the methanogenesis, the biogas, will be produced as an end product that will be utilized as the heat, electricity, such as biomethane in the form of fuel and a gas grid. Then the sludge that is used as a digestate, used as a fertilizer, soil conditioner and livestock bedding, and that is sludge can be utilized. So this is the overall steps that is involved in the formation of biogas. And what are the role of microbiology here? It has two important organism, that is biogas microorganism, mainly bacteria. There are two types. One is methane producing organisms, methanogens, non-methane producing organism. The non-methane producing organisms that act on the initial step, such as hydrolytic pathway and acidogenic pathway and acetogenic pathway, that is fermentative bacteria and hydrogen producing acetogenic bacteria. These are non-methane bacteria. Okay, methane producing bacteria. These are methanogen. The first stage, the fermentative bacteria. What is happening inside the biogas plant? Okay, so in the first stage, the fermentative bacteria that hydrolyze and ferment the organic substance, the cellulose decomposing bacteria act on the cellulose, and that will be converted into other saccharides into smaller forms. The protein decomposing bacteria will be act on a protein that produces, that has amino acid. The fat decomposing bacteria, that is act on fatty acids and lipid. Finally, you will be having lot of volatile acids and hydrogen and carbon dioxide. This step is known as acidogenesis, formation of acid. The second step, the hydrogen producing acetogenic bacteria that will be obtained, this that is produced, the volatile acid that is produced during this particular step will be decomposed by this this hydrogen producing acetogenic bacteria, where it produce acetic acid, hydrogen and carbon dioxide. The last stage, the methane producing bacteria, they convert the substrate that produces both 1 and 2 into methane and carbon dioxide. So this is the overall role of microorganism that is utilized to produce biogas, and this is known as the biogas. The major substrate that is used for the production of biogas are the animal waste, such as dung, urine of cattle, buffalo, goat, sheep, slaughterhouses waste, etc. Byproducts such as tobacco waste, bagasse and bran, etc. Aquatic plants like algae, water, hyacinth, okay. Then crop residues, straw, fodder, wheat, crops, stubbles, stick of cotton and jutes, okay. The forest residues such as branches, leaves, twigs and barks, okay. So the urban solid waste such as paper and other domestic waste, okay. Human waste such as night soil, but remember that you should not add any non-biodegradable waste such as plastic and some such kind of a high level, non-biodegradable substance. Then what are the factors which involved in the production of biogas? So the most important factors are the carbon nitrogen ratio, temperature, retention time, loading rate, hydrogen ion concentration, pH, total solid and feed rate, types of feedstock, nutrients and degree of mixing. So these are the major types of factors which are influencing the biogas production. So how the carbon nitrogen ratio will be influenced? The what do you mean by carbon nitrogen ratio? This is very, very important. The ratio of carbon to nitrogen present in the feed material is known as carbon is to nitrogen ratio. So the optimum concentration of this particular ratio is very, very important. That is approximately 20 to 30 is to 1. 20 to 30, that is carbon is to 1 part nitrogen. Then the next one is the temperature. You know that the adequate temperature is very, very important for the growth of methanogenic bacteria. The adequate temperature is 35 to 38 degrees centigrade. Most of the organisms are mesophiles, but there are hyperthermophilic or thermophilic bacteria also. Next one is the retention time. This is the length of time the material is subjected to the anaerobic digestion. In a digester is known as a retention time, or the theoretical time that particular volume of feedstock remains in the digester. The theoretical time that particular volume of the digester remains in the digester is known as retention time, and this retention time will vary depending on the substrate. Then the loading rate, it is very, very important. It is the amount of raw material fed into the digester per day per unit volume. That is known as loading rate. Okay. The loading rate is, it is the amount of raw material fed to the digester per day per unit volume. So the if that reactor is fully loaded or overloaded, acid production will happen that causes gas production, that causes that adversely affect the gas production rate. Okay, that causes impact in the gas production rate. Next one is the pH. So as you all know, the initial pH of the biogas plant, initially the acid formation will happen. At that particular time, the pH will be slightly acidic. Then the process, then acetogenesis is already over, then methane is started producing, the pH will be increases as the volatile acid and the nitrogen components are digested to that is methane. Initially the volatile fatty acids during hydrolysis and the acetogenesis gives an acidic pH. Then later this acetogenesis convert this the methanogenesis convert all this end product, the volatile acid, to the methane. Then that particular time the pH will be increases, that is reaches to slightly alkaline. The ideal pH is 6.5 to 7.5, where most of the microorganism will be ideally will be grown. The next one is the total solid content. The raw cow dung is the major components in the anaerobic digestion. Okay, the cow dung is the major component. So this cow dung contains 80 to 82% of moisture, and the balance 18 to 20% is the total solid. Okay, so thus cow dung is mixed usually in the proportion of 1:1 to get a solid content of 8 to 10%. Okay, so you have to mix the cow dung properly, so you will be getting 8 to 10% solid content. The next one is the feed rate. Uniform feeding is very, very important. The digester must be fed at the same time every day with a balanced feed rate, with the same quantity and quality. So that is very, very important. The next one is the type of feedstock. Okay, so the what are the major types of substrate we are going to use? All plant and animal waste can be used as a feed for the digester. When the feedstock is wood or contain more amount of lignin, the digestion become difficult. Okay, plant material has lot of cellulose is fine, but it has woody content, that is the composed of lignin, it is very difficult to break. Then the microorganism need to produce extra enzyme, then the digestion will become very, very slow. Then the nutrients, the major nutrient requirements that is present in the bacteria in a digester are carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus and sulfur. Okay, but methanogens, they don't want this oxygen, the remaining hydrogen and other things, sulfur etc., are utilized by other organism. So the proper balance of nutrient and extra, that is very much essential. Okay, the proper balance of the nutrients are very much essential. If in case that is not there, an extra raw material that is very rich in phosphorus, that is night soil or chopped leguminous plants, should be added along with the cow dung, so in order to balance the nutrient content. Next one is the degree of mixing. The slurry, the mixture, is properly mixed and the bacteria get their food supply. Okay, the mixing should be proper, the slurry is properly mixed and the bacteria get their food supply. So the slight mixing, that is improve the fermentation, but over mixing would create a lot of problem. So these are the major parameters that is used to for the production of biogas. Then where it is carrying out the biogas, is the digestion is carrying out in a biogas plant. Okay, so this biogas plant consisting of a source to supply the feedstock, the digestion tank for biogas production, the biogas recovery unit to isolate the produced biogas, and the heat exchangers to maintain the temperature of the digester. It should be, it should have a source to supply the feedstock, the digestion tank for biogas production. Then there should be the biogas recovery unit to isolate the produced biogas, and the heat exchangers to maintain the temperature of the biogas. So all the bio waste are added to the planet at an input input pipe, and the slurry of ducts are fed into the anaerobic digester. Then the slurry is converted with a floating cover. The slurry is covered with the floating cover. Then the gas produced due to the microbial activity. So whatever we have discussed, all these steps will be happening there. And what will happen? Due to the microorganisms, various microorganisms gives a lot of activity. Then finally, the produced biogas, which is supplied to the respective place through the connected pipes, and that can be used for cooking and lighting. Okay. Finally, the slurry can be removed through an outlet, and that can be used as a fertilizer and soil conditioner later. So this is the biogas power plant. So here you can see, as we have discussed, this is the ultrastructure of a biogas power plant. Here you can see that is made up of a brick unit, that is a mixing tank where you are going to add all those waste material. Okay, and there is an inlet pipe. Okay, there is a big digestion tank, you can see, and the mixture, whatever you are adding to this particular tank, it will mix properly and it will be feeding towards this particular tank. And this is inlet tank where you have seen there is a covering with the bricks and there is a partition wall. Okay, so this is what it is important. Now once this is already over, this partition wall, this is an inlet, and this is the overflow tank. Okay, the overflow tank is there. The activity will be happening here, and the gas that is collected from this particular chamber will be collected to the gas holder, and the gas, there will be a gas control valve, and that can be used to connect the pipe. By using a pipe, that can be used to connect your stove, and that stove can be biogas can be used to burn the stove, and that can be used as a bio energy. This is one of the most economically and applied aspects of biotechnology as well. Then if you look at the composition of biogas, how it is produced over here, so that is the main component is methane. 50-70% is methane, then approximately 30-40% of carbon dioxide, then 5-10% of hydrogen, and 1-2% is nitrogen, and 0.3% is water vapor, that is water, and the remaining very trace amount of hydrogen sulfides are also present. Okay, so these are the composition of a biogas. Then what are the advantages of biogas? The biogas is very, very safe to use and cheap and a renewable source of energy. One of the most potential problem nowadays, you know that every day the bioenergy, the price for the gas, natural LPG gas, is increasing. Okay, nowadays there is a high demand for the energy bio fuels. Okay, so that is the bioenergy, especially the gas, it is very, very important commodity nowadays. It is so costly also. Then the next one is the biogas can be burned in stove to provide heat. Okay, this can be used to burn stove, and you can use for cooking. Then it is used to domestic and street lighting and cooking. Okay, then it is a highly eco-friendly approach and does not cause any harmful impact or pollution. Then it also used for driving engines. Okay, automobile engine, this biogas can be used. There are a lot of power plants are running in European countries. So it is easy to generate, transport and store. It is very easy to generate. We can transport by pipes and we can store it. And it improves the sanitation of the surrounding. It cleans all the surrounding, because all the waste material you can collect it, and that can be dumped into this biogas power plant where the mixing tank is present. You can dump. Then the residue, whatever it is left, the digestate, that can be used as a manure or fertilizer and soil container. So these are the major advantages of biogas. Then there are one or two disadvantages as well. So wherever there is a process, there will be cons, that is not efficient enough on a large scale. Okay, it is very difficult to make a large scale, because so much of waste material is required to dump actually. So the larger scale, the scaling up of this particular process in a larger level, it is very, very tough. And it contains certain impurities, okay? I have told you the composition itself, you can see there are some kind of impurity in addition to all those things. Then it is unstable and hazardous, okay? So sometimes it become hazardous, this gas become hazardous and create, especially hydrogen sulfide, all those kind of things are present that can be hazardous. So these are the disadvantages of bio gas. So that's all, dear students. We can glance through this important topic once again. It's very, very interesting and important topic. So we have discussed them, what is methanogenesis or biomethanation, how the process overview is happening, okay? What is the mechanism of methanogenesis, and the biochemistry of methanogenesis, what are methanogens, okay? Then what is the, how the biogas will be produced, what are the major steps involved in biogas production, then the major microorganisms and their role they're involved, okay? Then what may be a biogas plant, and what is a substrate used for biogas production, what are the main substrate, what are the main important factors which influence the biogas production, and how the structure of a biogas power plant is made, okay? Then what are the compositions of a biogas, what are the advantages and what are the drawbacks or demerits of biogas. So that's all, dear students. So these are the major textbook. You can refer any of the textbook and for environmental microbiology or solid waste management. And thank you, dear students. You can see this particular picture. This is a very huge biogas power plant that is present in the European countries. Okay, that's commonly present in Europe. This is a photograph that is taken from the sources. Okay, so thank you, dear students, for watching this particular class. So if you are having any doubt, you can write it to me, or if you can ask me. Thank you very much.